Steve Smith.
And I'm Jill Leiderman.
Today on Kidding Around, we're going to visit the dolphins at Brookfield Zoo. Going to make some peach coffee cake in our Kidding Around kitchen.
We'll hear some violin music. We'll celebrate St. Patrick's Day with some dancers, some art, and lots more.
So be sure to stay with us for lots of fun today on Kidding Around.
Kidding Around will return after these messages.
Like a lot of teachers, I urge my students to watch the People's Court. I think it's a good way to see how the law really works. After all, the cases are real, and so are the people. And you know, the kids seem to really enjoy the experience. Thank heaven for the People's Court. Besides, I think they learn some valuable lessons. I know I do.
If you have been a lawful permanent resident of the United States for at least 5 years, you may qualify for citizenship. My name is Virginia Martinez, General Counsel for the Latino Institute and Director of the Institute's Naturalization Project. You can gain many benefits by becoming a United States citizen, including the right to vote. For more information about naturalization, call us at 663-3603.
I get angry just thinking about it makes me mad. Little kids doing drugs, it turns my stomach. That stuff hurts. It stops you from living up to your potential. It holds you back. It hurts the user. It hurts his family. And it hurts his friends. I just want to shake some sense into you kids that are using drugs and thinking about using it. So remember, don't, or else. Okay?
Call 1-800-554-KIDS. For more information,
the best way to start your business Monday is to join us for Strictly Business on Sunday night. We'll not only give you a useful mix of business news, we'll help you anticipate industry and economic developments, evaluate trends on Wall Street, and let you in on the thoughts and views of those corporate and government leaders who so often influence the direction and quality of our business lives. In other words, we can help give your business an edge come Monday morning. The time has come for Strictly Business Sunday night at 10:45 on Channel 5.
Now back to Kidding Around.
Well, believe it or not, St. Patrick's Day is upon us once again. Can you believe it?
I don't know.
Do you make a big deal out of this holiday?
Well, I wear green.
That's
my
enough.
Pants.
That's enough. Everyone is an honorary Irishman on St. Patrick's Day. You know, one of these days I really want to go to Ireland. You know, another name for Ireland is the Emerald Isle.
Why?
Well, because the rolling hills and the meadows are so lush and green, it looks like an emerald.
Oh, beautiful.
Doesn't that sound beautiful?
Very nice. Yeah. I don't go to Ireland. Yeah. I wear green pants or a green shirt, and I wear a little shamrock, like the one you stole from me.
Oops. Yeah, well, we're going to do some other things later on in honor of St. Patrick's Day, but right now, we're going to hear some very beautiful violin music.
10-year-old Jennifer Turner, a fifth grader at University of Chicago Lab School, will play Dance, composition by Norman Lloyd.
Here now is Jennifer Turner, who will be accompanied on the piano by Mrs. Carolyn Tisdale.
Thank you.
both of you, thank you so much. Jennifer, how long have you been taking lessons?
6.5 years.
Very good. And how long do you have to practice every day?
1.5 hours.
That sounds like hard work. Where do you perform?
Well, I study with Mr. George Perlman in the Fine Arts Building, and I just perform around.
I understand you have a special solo concert coming up?
Yes, I do.
Oh, that sounds great. Good luck with it. Now, you have taken a neat trip to France, right?
Yes, I have.
Could you tell us a little about that?
Well, we went to a French chalet and stayed with French children and had a French correspondent. And there we just stayed for 3 weeks and then went to Issy-les-Moulineaux right outside of Paris, where we stayed with a French child's family.
And everything was French.
Yes.
Sounds very nice. Now, when you're not going to France or you're not practicing violin, what do you like to do in your spare time?
Well, I like to read, but when I grow up, I want to be a cardiologist.
Very good. Well, thank you so much, both of you, for such a nice performance. Steve?
Time now to talk about animals. And our animal for today is really wonderful. It's the dolphin, which is also called a porpoise. Now, it may look like a fish, but it's really a mammal. And dolphins are found in oceans all over the world.
I'm with Brenda Woodhouse, senior keeper of marine mammals here at Brookfield Zoo. Hi, Brenda.
Hi there.
What kind of dolphins are these?
These animals are Atlantic bottlenose dolphins.
Yes, that means they come from the Atlantic Ocean.
That's right.
How many different kinds of dolphins are there?
Well, there's anywhere over 35. It just depends. A lot of people classify them, you know, split them up as such. But there's quite a few variety of dolphins and porpoises.
They're such pretty animals. Tell us about one of these dolphins. All the different parts.
The different parts. Well, these are, first of all, they're mammals. A lot of people think they're fish. And they are mammals. That means they're warm-blooded. They breathe air. They bear their young lives. They nurse their young. And at one time in their life, they even have hair. One of the most noticeable things in the animals, they have front flippers, they have a dorsal fin and tail flukes. And all of these aid the animal when they swim through the water, and they can reach speeds up to about 30 miles an hour.
You're kidding.
Very fast animals.
The dorsal fin, that's the one on the back.
That's the one on the top,
right. They have a lot of teeth, don't they?
They have anywhere from 80 to 100 teeth.
Good grief. What do you feed them here?
What we feed them is a variety of fish. We feed them two types of mackerel, feed them herring, and a fish known as blue runner. We like to give them a variety of fish as much as possible.
Now, you have a show here with... Now, first of all, what's the difference between a dolphin and a porpoise? I was going to say you have a porpoise show, but there's a difference, isn't there?
They're very similar, yes, but there is a difference. They look a lot alike. A dolphin, though, has a snout, where a porpoise doesn't. A dolphin's teeth are conical shape, and a porpoise's are flat. And their dorsal fin, a porpoise is perfectly triangular, where a dolphin's is just a little bit different. But otherwise, they look a lot alike.
Okay, they do lots of different kinds of tricks. How hard is it to train a dolphin?
Well, it just depends on the animal. Each animal learns at a different rate. They can learn anywhere from a few moments to a year, depending on what you're trying to teach him. For an example, the somersault took Nemo about 6 months, took Shauna a year, and Wendy learned it just by imitation.
Well, they're really intelligent animals, and they look like they have fun. Are they enjoying the tricks they do?
I think most of the time. Sometimes they don't want to perform, and then they don't, and there's nothing you can do about it. You know, they just decide.
You mean you can have a grumpy dolphin on your hands?
You definitely can have a grumpy dolphin, or one that sulks, or all kinds of personalities in these animals.
Now, do they know you? Do they recognize your voice?
I don't know that they recognize my voice. These animals rely a lot on their sight and sonar. They, in the wild, don't relate to sounds above the surface of the water because they have no need for that. But if I walk by in my street clothes, either above the tank or in the underwater windows, they can pick me out from the rest of the crowd. So obviously they recognize me.
Well, we recognize you too. Thanks so much, Brenda.
Well, thank you.
I'm here in the Kidding Around Book Nook with a few books that I read and would like to tell you about. First, a funny family story called The Plunking of Joshua T. Bates by Susan Shreve. Poor Josh finds out from his mom that he has to repeat third grade. As if that's not enough bad news for Josh, his friends make fun of him and beat him up because he's flunking. Everyone seems to be on Josh's case until he starts to deal with his learning problem with the help of his teacher. This story is really cute and has big type, so for kids 9 to 12, this book is a lot of laughs. Next is a super book for you brace faces. For those of us unfortunate kids or adults who have metal braces on our teeth, this book gives some soothing advice for relief. Smile, How to Cope with Braces by Jean Benacourt, a book I wish I had when I had braces, tells people the history of braces, what kind of food to eat, pain to expect, and do's and don'ts of braces. If you have railroad tracks, this book is a great choice. Lastly, did you know that in high school, actor Robin Williams was voted least likely to succeed? This piece of trivia and lots more can be found in this book, You Can't Show Kids in Underwear and Other Little-Known Facts About Television, written and illustrated by Barbara Suling. It has lots of serious and funny facts that came from way back to the beginning of television all the way to now. This book has neat trivia for every age from 10 to 110 years old. Well, that's it for our look at books today. If any of these books sound good to you, you can check them out at your local library. Steve?
Well, time now to check out things in the music world. Today's featured musical artist began his career 20 years ago with a rock and roll band called The Echoes. Then there was The Lost Souls, The Emerald Lords, and many, many more. Today we know this singer not for his bands, but for, well, just the way he is. I'm talking about Billy Joel. Billy Joel has had lots of hit singles at the top of the Billboard charts over the years, including Piano Man, Captain Jack, and of course, Just the Way You Are. Today we're going to listen to a hit single from Billy's latest album called An Innocent Man. The song is Keeping the Faith.
If it seems like I've been lost, then let's remember. You think I'm feeling
Keeping the Faith by the one and only Billy Joel. Right now, let's join up with Jill.
In honor of the Irish holiday, St. Patrick's Day, we're going to take a look at some of your favorite stars who have an Irish heritage. Actress and daughter of the late Bing Crosby, Mary Crosby, is of Irish descent. Her great-grandfather on her father's side was born and raised in Ireland. Mary hit showbiz success just after landing a role on the TV show Dallas for one season. But Mary doesn't think showbiz is everything. The most important things are her husband, her animals, and her books. Actor Michael Keaton, who recently completed the movie Touch and Go, is also Irish. His grandmother and great-grandfather on his mother's side are from County Mayo, Ireland, which is on the west coast of the country. Michael was born and raised in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and is the youngest of seven children. Michael said he knew he would go into acting at the age of five when he began doing Elvis impressions. Aaron Moran, formerly of the TV shows Happy Days and Joni Loves Chachi, has grandparents from Galway in Ireland. Aaron began her television career when she was just 5 years old by making more than 20 TV commercials and several guest appearances on TV shows. When Aaron was 12, she landed the role of Joni on Happy Days. Now that Happy Days has gone out of production, Aaron hopes to get a good script and a good role in a feature film. Actor Pierce Brosnan, who plays Remington Steele in the TV show of the same name, is probably one of the most well-known Irishmen on TV. Pierce was born in County Meath, Ireland, and moved to England when he was 11 years old. Pierce is married to actress Cassandra Harris. They live with their three children in Hollywood, California. And that's all for the Irish celebrity news today.
Thank you very much. And we'll be giving you an address for Remington Steele Pierce Brosnan a little bit later in the show.
But when we come back, we'll hear some Irish dancing and we'll make a peach coffee cake.
So be sure to stay with us for lots more fun today. I'm kidding around.
We will return after these messages.
Quiet.
Sports Machine, Sunday night at 11 here on Channel 5.
I come here a lot. It's something to do. You know, pass the time, stay out of trouble. I do really good here, all by myself.
This kid volunteered to spend a couple of hours with someone this weekend. No one took him up on it. Call Big Brothers and Sisters of Chicago, 427-0637, now.
Most emergencies in this country aren't national. They happen state by state by state. And there's a branch of America's armed forces that's first to come to a state's rescue, the Army National Guard, trained to be a partner of the Army in national defense.
Move to checkpoint 8, out.
Then putting that training to work to protect your town and state.
If it gets any higher, we're gonna have to get those people out.
And for 2 days a month of your time, you can be there, earning extra pay and learning new skills while you're helping people.
Thank God you're here.
Join us. Give us 2 days a month of your time. You'll be keeping the Army National Guard strong and our country, our state, and our neighbors a little more.
Eddies!
When you have a part-time, smart-time job with the Army National Guard, you're part of America at its best. Call toll-free.
Now back to Kidding Around.
We're in our Kidding Around kitchen, and we're going to do some baking now with 13-year-old Jason Pranger from New Lenox, Illinois. Jason is going to show us how to make a peach coffee cake. Hi, Jason.
Hi.
Jason, that's a really impressive-looking peach coffee cake you have there. Very professional.
Thank you.
I like it. What ingredients do we need to make?
We need a quarter cup of margarine, 3 ounces of cream cheese, 2 cups of biscuit mix, 1/3 cup of milk, and 1/2 cup of peach preserves.
Okay, and what utensils do we need?
We need a spatula, pastry blender, knife, wooden spoon, and a rolling pin. We need cookie sheets, balls, and cutting board.
Okay, all this stuff is sitting there waiting for us to bake, so let's go to it. What do we have to do first?
We add the 1/4 cup of margarine and the 3 ounces of cream cheese to the two cups of biscuit mix.
Slap it in there, okay?
This is cut in with a pastry blender.
What do you mean cut in?
It's a term for mixing.
Okay.
Now, I've got this done over here.
There you go.
We add the 1/3 cup of milk and stir this together.
How long do we have to stir it for?
Until it is mixed well.
Okay.
Then when that is finished, which is that, it is packed together with your hands and then placed on a wooden board.
There you go.
To roll, to knead. To knead, you press out, turn in, turn, and repeat. This is done 8 to 10 strokes. Okay. Now it is flattened and placed on a sheet of wax paper and is rolled to an 8 by 12 inch rectangle, about 1/8 inch.
How thin does it have to be?
Pretty nicely thin.
Okay.
Now, it has to be flipped, so I slip a small cookie sheet underneath it, place a large one on top,
and, whoa, like a peach that you're flipping, huh?
Yeah.
Should I peel this off of you?
Yes.
Okay, I'll take that.
Okay, now the preserves are spread down the center.
Does it have to be, like, evenly down the center?
Try to.
Okay. Can you use anything else besides peach preserves?
Yes, you can use any type of preserves, really. Now, cut strips at intervals about 1 to 1.5 inches.
Okay. Can you use fresh fruit for the middle?
Yes, sometimes you can, depending on what it is, really.
Okay. Okay, now what do we do with these little flaps here?
We fold them over.
On top of the preserves.
Right.
Okay. After we've got them all flapped over, what can we do?
We place it in the oven to bake at 425 degrees.
Okay.
This is done for 12 to 15 minutes.
You answered my question. Does it have to be preheated?
Yes, it does.
Okay. This is now we've got it in the oven and we're ready to look at the finished one here. That's really nice. Can we put any kind of frosting on there?
Yes. It's frosted with confectionate sugar and milk.
Very nice. Well, that's really nice. What else do you make?
I like to make dinner, breakfast, and dessert.
What's your favorite thing to cook?
This, really.
I understand you're in a 4-H group with this recipe, right?
Yes, I did a demonstration at county level, and I went down to state with it also.
Wonderful. I'd love to make it sometime. Thank you so much, Jason, for your recipe. And if any of you would like Jason's recipe for a peach coffee cake, just write and let us know. Steve?
In honor of St. Patrick's Day, we're going to see a four-hand reel. It'll be performed for us by 4 students from the John and Mary Meyer School of Irish Dancing. The dancers will be accompanied by Mary Meyer on the tin whistle and Paul McHugh on guitar.
Thank you.
Paul McHugh, and dancers. Come on back here. Let's meet our dancers by name and age, and we'll start right here.
Carol's name.
All righty.
Tom Hurdle, he 10.
Let's scooch over here.
Paul Meyer, 11.
Hi, Paul.
Julie Meyer, 10.
That was really swell. Where do you perform?
Well, all weekend we're going to be performing around the city, and we're going to be in the parade.
Great. Okay, that's really great. Have any of you ever been to Ireland, or is your family from Ireland? We got some yeses and some no's. You've been there?
I've been there. My parents, but both of my parents are from Ireland.
Wonderful. How about you?
No.
You'd like to go someday, right?
Yeah.
Well, my mom is from Ireland.
My mom is too.
So your mom is from here, right? And Paul, what about you?
I'm from Belfast, from Ireland.
Oh, thank you. What a wonderful accent.
Thank you.
Thanks for being with us. Happy St. Patrick's Day to you. Jill?
We have some great St. Patrick's Day art to see on our art wall now, and we'd like to thank the kids and schools who sent it in, especially St. Patrick Elementary School in St. Charles, Illinois, Robert Healy Elementary School in Chicago, and Abbott School in Chicago. Now let's take a look at our special art.
Thanks for the great artwork. And now, of course, it's
mailbox!
Let's check in with the KA mailbox and see what goodies we got this week. Mr. Hand. Ah, top of the morning to you. Thank you very much. A shamrock. I'll give this to you since I took yours.
Oh, thank you.
I don't have any mail in there. Thank you very much and happy St. Patrick's Day to you. All right, some for you and some for me if I don't trip and fall down.
Okay.
Let us begin with a limerick. Now, this comes from Kelly Woods of the Healy School. There was a leprechaun named Pat. He wore a funny green hat. He ran here and there. He ran everywhere, this leprechaun named Pat. I love limericks. And now, how about a riddle? This one was sent in by Ruben Martinez. When a leprechaun races to get away from five tigers, what time is it?
I don't know. What time is it?
Five after one. All right, we'll try another one. Here we go. This is from Edmund Kaleo of the Healy School. What did the leprechaun find in the pot at the end of the rainbow?
I don't know. What did the leprechaun find at the end of the rainbow in the pot?
You're good. Irish stew.
Okay, a limerick from Brian Sweeney. There was a leprechaun named Mike who took a very long hike. He was so strong and bold that he found a pot of gold. That lucky leprechaun named Mike. Okay, from a girl named Rose from the Healy School. A riddle. What do you say to a three-headed leprechaun?
I give up. What do you say to a three-headed leprechaun?
Hello, hello, hello.
Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. All right, we got another riddle here, right?
Oh, no. No, this is a poem.
A poem, oh, yeah.
Roses are red, violets are blue, shamrocks are green, and so are you. That's probably directed toward you,
Thank
Steve.
You so much.
As we promised, we have actor Pierce Brosnan's address for you. As you know, Pierce plays Remington Steele on the TV series. You can write to Pierce, care of MTM Enterprises, 4063 Radford Avenue, Studio City, California, 91604. That's Pierce Brosnan, care of MTM Enterprises, 4063 Radford Avenue, Studio City, California, 91604.
Thank you very much. And as always, if you have a joke, riddle, picture, or poem you would like to share with us, or if you would like the recipe for Jason's peach coffee cake, just write and let us know. Here is our address.
Kidding Around, WMAQ-TV, 19th floor of the Merchandise Mart, Chicago, Illinois, 60654.
Bravo, bravo, bravo. bravo, another great day, another great show. Happy St. Patrick's Day to everybody. We'd like to thank all of our guests for being with us today, and thank you for joining us, too.
I still want my shamrock back.
All right, all right, all right.
Next week on Kidding Around, we'll meet Harlem Globetrotter Curly Neal. We'll see a pom-pom squad in action.
We're going to see some animals and lots, lots more.
So join us for some more Kidding Around fun next Saturday at 12 noon and Sunday at 7 a.m.
Right. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Your riddles, jokes, poems, and art. Send them to Kidding Around, WMAQ-TV, 194 of the Merchandise Mart, Chicago, Illinois, 60654.